Yeah, it's about that time again.
WNLR New Level Radio. New Level Radio. WNLR New Level Radio. Live in the red, live in the set. WNLR New Level Radio.
Yeah, welcome to WNLR New Level Radio. I'm your host, N.I.L.E, you know what I mean? And this is episode number 3, you know what I mean? And this is episode 3 of our Celebrity Chaos episode, you know what I'm saying? And before we get into that, we just want to thank everybody for tuning in to WNLR New Level Radio. You could have been anywhere else listening to any other podcast, but you chose to be here with us for the moment. And we greatly, greatly, greatly appreciate that. Just know we don't take that for granted. Alright, now we're going to get back into episode 3 of our Celebrity Chaos episodes, you know what I mean? And those of you just tuning in, you know, you can go ahead and check out the pre-podcast of episode 1, which was the Bill Cosby conviction. Episode 2 was the Kanye West slavery statement, you know what I mean? And now we are into episode 3 of our Celebrity Chaos, and this is what's going on. It's crazy, y'all. And I just don't know what to say. But you know what? I just got to put it out there and bring some comments on it. Now, check it out. This is episode 3 of our Celebrity Chaos episode. And our Celebrity Chaos that we're speaking of now is an actress by the name of Allison Mack. Okay? Now, for all of you who don't really know Allison Mack, you will know Allison Mack if you see her face. You know, basically, Allison Mack is the actress who played Chloe Sullivan on the actual Superman rendition episode or remake of Smallville. You know what I mean? So her name is Allison Mack, and she played Chloe Sullivan on Smallville, which was basically the Superman show where it shows Superman growing up from a child and developing into the Man of Steel. You know what I mean? So that's for all the DC fans or whatever the case is out there who know about the comic books and everything. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. But we're talking about Allison Mack. Now, here's what's going on with Allison Mack, and this is according to Hollywood Reporter. You know what I mean? Essentially, Allison Mack apparently was involved or allegedly involved in a sex trafficking ring of children. It's crazy. You know what I mean? And I didn't hear a lot about this on the internet so much because there was so much going on, again, with the Bill Cosby and then Kanye West. I had to make this a podcast for episode 3, Celebrity Chaos. I had to do it. Simply because, listen, Smallville is one of those shows, you understand what I mean? Which is basically a comic book narrative, you know, of, you know, the creation of Superman, you know what I mean? And most of the people who are comic book buffs like me, you know, DC and Marvel, you know what I'm saying? Of course, I'm primarily Marvel. We're going to get into a podcast with that episode later. So, but we're talking about now. We're talking about Allison Mack. She's the actress who played Chloe Sullivan in the TV series called Smallville, you know what I mean? So, with that, it's very, very cool because what ends up happening is that you look at these characters, you know what I mean? And you look at the actresses, and sometimes we don't really truly know the actual actors or actresses. We don't really know how to separate them from their roles of what they play from who they are in real life. You know what I mean? And that goes with most actors, essentially. But I just thought it very interesting because if you look at Allison Mack, you know what I mean? She looks very beautiful, you know what I'm saying? Very wholesome, has that very bubbly mentality while in her show. You understand what I mean? As Chloe Sullivan. But, you know, actors and actresses, they are trained to give you the impression they are people that they're not in real life. So, you know, with the news report of her being involved in, allegedly, a sex trafficking ring, you know, children, you know what I mean? And this being a white female, You understand what I mean? It's not unlikely in some people's minds, but I like to give people the benefit of the doubt. You know what I mean? But here's the story. Now, from Hollywood Reporter, it says that, like many in Hollywood, Max sought spiritual guidance outside the mainstream. But 12 years after checking out a woman's empowerment seminar, or checking out a woman's empowerment seminar, that's what she basically did, she stands accused of recruiting slaves and branding women with a hot cauterizing pen. Now, it says through interviews with close friends and ex-members of the NXIVM cult, I believe that's the name of the cult, THR, basically, which is the Hollywood Report, reveals how a charismatic fan favorite allegedly morphed into the leader's number two and explores the persistent allure and pernicious effects of cults on entertainment. You know what I mean? So I think that it's just wild, because apparently the cult is a NXIVM member. You know, it's spelled N-X-I-V-M member. So honestly, I don't know about, you know, again, these cults or whatever the case is. These are the type of situations where when you have cults and, you know, they're basically secret societies. They're basically supposed to be underground. They're supposed to be discreet, you know. They're not supposed to be publicly known. But ideally, it's just the idea that Allison Mack, you know, a actress, and apparently a very good one. You understand? I believe she's also a model. You know what I mean? But it's just wild how I just see this a lot. And people don't believe it's nothing new, but I find that when you deal with cults of any nature, you know what I mean? It's funny how, you know, somebody like Allison Mack, you understand what I mean, gets this actual stamp on her, you know, for being a part of this cult. Now, apparently, also allegedly, you know, the connections of her being able to have these sex slaves, which ideally seem like they were mostly female based on the article of the Hollywood Report, she was also being backed by a billionaire who was actually supporting and funding this. Now, I don't know the name of the report, but you can go to the Hollywood Report and you can go ahead and read it for yourself. But I just wanted to comment on this for our Celebrity Chaos episode because, you know, again, we have so much going on in the news, you know what I mean? And for me, you know, I just find it that with the two top topics that seem to have rock the internet viral, you know what I mean? Allison Mack is a very popular character on Smallville. Smallville is a very popular show, you know what I mean? Now, she may not be one of those A-list actors, but for the show Smallville, that's a very powerful franchise show. So she's very well known, you know? And of course, you know, you have a lot of the main actors like Tom Welling, you know what I mean, and Michael Rosenbaum. You know, Michael Rosenbaum, he actually played Lex Luthor, you know what I mean, in Smallville. But for those of you who don't know, and this is for all my DC buffs, he also plays the voice of the Flash in the animated Justice League, you know, movies. You understand what I mean? So Michael Rosenbaum also plays the voice of the Flash, you know what I mean? So it's cool that, you know, you have the DC, you know, franchise. They keep the actors, you know what I mean? Even with voiceovers, they keep them in the whole entire DC spectrum, whether it's animated, you know, in DC Warner Brothers, they actually do the animated movies. So again, but we're talking about Allison Mack, okay? She's the woman who played Chloe Sullivan, you know, on the TV series Smallville. And again, I just find it interesting that, you know, she's apparently found, you know, allegedly, you know, involved in a sex slave ring. And they don't just say she's involved in it. Apparently, the allegations say that she is one of the second, you know, biggest leaders involved in it. The second biggest leaders, not just a participant, but somebody who actually is doing the trafficking. And I find this interesting because, again, I looked on the internet, you know what I mean? And it pops up if you Google it, you know, but in light of this being the celebrity chaos episodes of WNLR New Level Radio, you know what I mean? My first episode that I talked about was Bill Cosby and the conviction with all of the actual allegations of rape. You know what I mean? Now, keep in mind, there were a lot of women coming forward about Bill Cosby, okay? But also, Kanye West. He was the second episode topic of Celebrity Chaos, you know what I mean? In regards to his comment about slavery, you know what I mean? Now, what's interesting to me, though, is that these two stories seem to get a lot more shine than Allison Mack does, you know what I mean? Because Kanye West is a rapper, you know what I mean, of course, but Bill Cosby is a very huge, you know, celebrity, you know, mogul in his own right, you know what I mean? Done a lot, you know, for the black community. He's promoted a lot of, you know, college and education for a lot of black Americans, you know? So I think that I just find it interesting that a story like Allison Mack, you understand what I mean? And her being one of the second ringleaders or people who actually are involved in a sex slave, you know, ring that's backed by a billionaire. You understand what I'm saying? And again, a story like that, I would think that would overshadow and be the first top priority story over somebody like Bill Cosby and Kanye West. But, you know, just in my opinion, as we know, you know, the media can spin everything that they want to spin. And as we all know also, there's a thing and there's a term that's called media consolidation, which actually gives the, you know, idea that when you put news reports, like let's say on Fox or on CNN, if you put news reports in 15-minute loops and constantly keep playing those actual loops over and over and over and over again, what happens is there's a psychological impression that it leaves on the audience that views it. Now, be clear, you know, you got to remember that all of the program directors who run these actual news stations and programs or whatever the case is, they have deep, 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 deep pockets because, again, they're connected with people who want to have stuff shown that they want shown. So, again, I think that my biggest issue is that with Allison Mack, you know, she's not, like I said, not like a super A-list character, but she is very popular. But again, with her having a story like this and a story of her having being involved, or like I said, allegedly, I'm just going by what the Hollywood Report says. Now, allegedly being a sex slave leader, you understand what I mean? Of girls or women. This is a white Caucasian woman, you know? And it's funny how that doesn't even seem to outshadow what Bill Cosby has done or allegedly done or has been convicted of doing and the statement that Kanye West made. Now, I want to make the comparison between the two. Here's the crazy part. You have every woman's rights organization. Every woman's rights organization. You have the Me Too movement, you know what I mean, which I greatly support, with women bold enough to come out saying that they had their actual courage to say that they were sexually assaulted, you know what I mean? And I commend these women, honestly. I commend these women who basically started this movement. And I believe that the intent of the movement is wonderful. And as a man, I personally support it because essentially women haven't been the only ones who've been raped or molested too. You understand what I'm saying? They've happened to men all the time. And I think that sometimes what has happened is that the narrative of what's popular or what is in the limelight at the time, like for the Me Too movement, there's a lot of women who came out, and it was a movement that basically started on Instagram, you understand what I'm saying, and Twitter, you know, and that was a beautiful thing. So I believe that when it comes to the Me Too movement and then the actual allegations of all these powerhouse male figures, you know what I mean, Donald Trump being one of them, you know, and all of these dynamics of the sexual assault, the sexual abuse, the sexual allegations, not to mention with all of the actual craziness that was going on with the actual Olympic doctor. You understand what I mean? Who basically was convicted, you know what I mean, of having all of these misappropriations sexually with all these Olympic, you know, gold medalists and everybody. You know what I mean? So all of that was really brought out from the Me Too movement. So again, shout out to the Me Too movement. WNLR, New Level Radio, got much love for y'all. You know what I mean? And that's a very beautiful thing. But I want to say this. With the Me Too movement, you understand what I mean? And all the women's rights organizations, for somebody like Allison Mack to be accused of running a sex slave ring with children, apparently, and women, I'm surprised that I didn't hear anything about that. I'm surprised that I didn't hear anything regarding these women of the Me Too movement speak out and put Allison Mack on blast. You understand what I mean? That's the thing that I believe that makes this Celebrity Chaos episode 3 so unique, and why I had to do it. Because again, Bill Cosby was actually convicted of raping multiple women. And this was a case that was possibly 50 or 60 years old. And that's the crazy part that I don't understand. But again, I believe that the media, and also I blame this on the judicial system. I blame this on the judicial system, because we can't just pick and choose who we want to actually convict or bring into light, or what case is relevant to hear. You know what I mean? To me, if you're a celebrity, any celebrity on any level, you should be treated just like every citizen, ideally. You understand? But I think about the actual senator. I believe her name was Senator Warren. You know what I mean? She said this in an interview when she was actually, I believe, in Congress. You know, she was speaking. And this was a powerful thing. She basically said that when it comes to law and it comes to the rules and regulations of our country and the laws, there are two sets of rules and laws. They're the set of rules and laws that are for those in the elite positions, like the actual judges themselves, the people in Congress, the political people, you know what I mean, who have political influence. And then there's the rules and regulations that are for everybody else. So essentially what she was saying is that, look, there's a double standard here. There's a double standard where the people who are actually creating the laws, the people who actually have influence on the laws, like the Congress, the House of Representatives, the Senate, you know, House of Delegates, any officials, even the police officers, you understand what I mean? They seem to go by a different set of rules, or rather, let me say, not go by a different set of rules, but they seem to be exception to the rules that are created. And mind you, those rules and regulations and laws that are legislated, these legislation of laws have to be passed by the people that we put in office. So again, the we the people are the ones who have to abide by these laws. But in actuality, we're the ones who actually present the laws so that they can put them on, you know, Congress, you know, they can go on Capitol Hill, they can go into the House of Delegates, and, you know, they can go into the state level, they go to the federal level, and they all get legislated on. But those people that we put in office are basically our representatives, or they're supposed to be. So long story short is that, you know, Senator Warren, she said that there are two different sets of laws. So I'm just saying that in respect to this episode 3 of Celebrity Chaos. You understand what I mean? That doesn't seem to be when it comes to you being a celebrity. You know what I mean? Because celebrities, depending on who they know, depending on what connections they have, unfortunately, it seems like some get more press than others. You know what I mean? Some people may feel like Allison Mack wasn't really popular or whatever, as far as more popular than Bill Cosby or Kanye West. But my belief is this: that's not true, because every celebrity has got to be popular, because otherwise they wouldn't be a celebrity. That's just my opinion. You know what I'm saying? But this is WNLR New Level Radio. This is episode 3. 3, you know what I mean? The Celebrity Chaos episode. And we're talking about the celebrity Allison Mack, who plays Chloe Sullivan on the actual TV show Smallville. You know what I mean? Which is basically the DC show that actually incorporates the life of Clark Kent coming to Earth before he actually developed into Superman. The whole show was about how Clark Kent evolved, and it showed how the characters in the Superman, you know, saga and the Superman legacy, like Lex Luthor and everybody, kind of played a role to show how they all grew up together. Well, Chloe Sullivan apparently was a Smallville High, you know, best friend of Clark Kent. So Chloe Sullivan in the actual show Smallville, Allison Mack, she is the actress who played Chloe Sullivan. So my question is this, okay? Do you believe that the Me Too movement and all of the women's rights organizations, you understand, take a blind eye to when women, celebrities or whoever they are, do you believe that the Me Too movement and women's organizations, you know, domestic violence organizations, do you believe that they take a blind eye and are quiet when it comes to women who actually do things or allegedly do things like what Allison Mack has been blatantly accused of, which is sex trafficking as a ringleader, you know, having sex slaves, okay? Do you believe that the Me Too movement and the people like the domestic violence organizations or whatever seem to take a blind eye to, you know, women who do things like this and don't promote it in the media as much? You know what I mean? Like women like Allison Mack, okay? Do you believe that they take a blind eye to it and don't promote it as much over situations such as Bill Cosby? You know what I mean? And other, you know, men who are powerhouse figures, like political figures, you know, whomever. Do you believe that there's a double standard when it comes to women's rights organizations? Like I say, some like the Me Too movement, domestic violence organizations, or women's empowerment movements altogether. Do you believe that there's a double standard when women commit these actual acts of atrocity like Allison Mack has been accused of, and they don't come forward publicly and boldly with the same boldness that they do with men that do it? That's essentially my question. You know what I mean? And I wanted to make sure that I was specific about that, because like I said, I want to make sure that I'm clear that the women's rights organizations, domestic violence organizations, the Me Too movement, everything about empowering women, I want to make sure that I'm clear that I support it. You understand what I mean? Because right is right and wrong is wrong. I'm a man of faith. You know, I believe in God, my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Like I said, God has his rules. He has his regulations. And that's what I go by. And everybody should be going by, regardless of male or female. But we're going by the principle here. Do you believe that these organizations, these women's rights organizations, do you believe they take a blind eye to situations and allegations like what Allison Mack has been actually alleged and been accused of with sex slave trading and trafficking? You understand what I mean? Do you believe that they take a blind eye to that when a woman does it, as opposed to when a man, somebody like Bill Cosby, has had allegations of, you know, rape or whatever the case is, or any other political figures, you know what I mean, that are of the male gender, okay? So you can go ahead and leave your comments, you know, right below the YouTube channel, you know what I mean? Or you can leave your comments on Facebook, you know what I mean? You can leave some comments on Instagram and Twitter as well, you know what I mean? So we're going to get into some music right now, you know what I mean? And I just want you to know, thank you all for tuning in. You know what I mean? We're going to get back to y'all in a second. We're going to go ahead and play this music. We're going to get back on this topic, because this is a very powerful topic when we're talking about episode 3 of the WNLR New Level Radio Celebrity Chaos episodes. And the celebrity we're talking about in episode 3 is Allison Mack. She is the actual superstar celebrity of the actual show Smallville, which is the whole Superman series about Clark Kent growing up into Superman. And she played Clark Kent's best friend all through Smallville High School. You know what I mean? So we're talking about her getting actual allegations and accused of sex trafficking, you know, and being one of the second leaders, the biggest leaders of the trafficking. You know what I mean? And the trafficking was of females. And she is a white Caucasian female involved in this. So let me just see what your comments are. You know what I mean? Like I said, this is WNLR New Level Radio.
WNLR New Level Radio.